One of the great things about William & Mary is that people genuinely love talking about their interests and their majors. And through this SciArt, I wanted to facilitate that. So we have students from very different majors discussing artwork and designing artwork together, and that's really something that can probably only happen at William & Mary. Some of those works that you can see in the gallery if you visit it are, for example, this quilt with 9 beautiful squares, and in each square is a different fractal pattern. Another piece is a portrait of kleptoplasty in nudibranchs, which is essentially chloroplast stealing. And it's a beautiful scientific illustration of nudibranchs, which are marine slugs. This artist, Elisa Glauser, she hand-painted all of these different species and then pieced them together on Photoshop. And it's just beautiful. And that piece really goes to show how scientific illustration can communicate really complex ideas in a way that's fairly easily digestible and accessible to a wide variety of people.
Each discipline here at the college has its own unique way of looking at and assessing and analyzing material and data, and that artists have a way of doing it that's different than scientists, and scientists just slightly different than artists. In those differences, the two of them can benefit from one another in order to make work, you know, artistic work that pushes boundaries, as well as approaching, you know, research in the scientific lab in ways that, had they just continued in the same direction, might not have occurred to them.
So my project that I submitted is a graphical abstract of a brittle star life cycle. And it was actually submitted as part of a grant, which I think is awesome that grants are requiring, or beginning to require, graphical abstracts with their written submissions. I think about all these problems we're facing, environmentally especially, in the 21st century, and how we need to pay attention to research now more than ever. And I think in order to reach the widest audience, we're going to need to use creative strategies and creative scientific communication to reach as many people as we possibly can and develop effective solutions to these problems.